The internet that we have today, the web 1 and the web 2, is based on the idea of the standalone computer, where people host data they might not own. For example, our bank hosts our personal data about how much money we have and how we spend our money, and Facebook hosts the data about who our friends are and which pictures we upload, etc., etc. Because data is stored centrally, which brings a lot of also questions about data control, like do we have control over our data? Do we even know what is happening with our data? Now, blockchain networks, this is one of the problems the current internet has. And the other problem the current internet has is there is no native way to transfer value. If I want to send you money, I cannot send you money directly. I need, especially if I don't know you and I don't trust you, I need a clearing institution, a PayPal, an e-commerce platform, or a bank. And what blockchain networks allow us to do is to have a native settlement layer for transferring values in the form of tokens. Some call it cryptocurrencies. But like technically speaking, they're tokens, and they can reflect different things. A token can be something similar to a currency, but it can also be a ticket to a concert. It could be represent, for example, a key to an Airbnb for a few days, like open my Airbnb apartment. A token could also represent a barrel of oil, etc., etc. So what blockchain networks allow us to do is to collectively manage tokens over the internet, and to have a value transfer network. Today, if we want to send value, we, for example, use a bank to send money from A to B, but it's not only one bank, it's several banks. And these banks make private money. In the Bitcoin network, we collectively manage a payment network, and the individual are contributed or are rewarded with a token to kind of to maintain this network, this common good, this public good. And anyone can use the network without having to be an explicit member of the network. The only thing you do when you transfer tokens over the network, you pay a fee, but you don't have to be a member, and you don't have to identify yourself, etc. So in the end, these blockchain networks allow us to collectively manage a purpose and kind of the rules of who is allowed to do what and when in the network are tied to the token. And if you kind of contribute to the network, you can earn a token. And in the case of Bitcoin, is if you maintain the integrity and the security of the network, you can earn a token. And this token is called Bitcoin. And this is why they call it also mining. And this is often misunderstood. People think that Bitcoin, for example, is an object of speculation. It has become an object of speculation, but first and foremost, it's a purpose-driven token that allows us to collectively steer a kind of people over the internet to maintain a public good. Does that make sense?
Does it make sense? Of course. But speaking of the commons again.
I think these guys here find it very funny in the first row.